Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about string manipulation. For this lesson, you will learn string basics, string indexing and slicing, string concatenation, and finally will be string methods. Let's start with introduction of string. First of all, strings are a type of data in Python that represent text and characters. Strings are extremely versatile and used in many areas, such as data processing, file handling, and web development. Normally, strings can be created with single quote. You look at this right now, this is a single quote here, or double quotes, which is this double quote here. So normally, we'll just use double quote for simplicity's sake. And next will be assign a string to a variable like this, hello string equal to double quotation, hello, and then double quotation here. So this is how you can assign a string value. For string indexing, each character in a string has an index starting from 0. It means that we can access characters in a string using brackets. Let's look at this example here. Hello string equal to open quotation, hello, and then closing quotation. So this is a assignment of a new variable. And how do we access the character inside this hello string? This will be the method here. Hello str bracket 0 will returns h. So why does it return h? Because the index will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is how you can access the character inside the string. Furthermore, negative indexing starts from the end, with negative 1 referring to the last character. For example, hello string equal to hello, and then hello string negative 1 returns O here. Why does it return O? Because O is the last character inside this hello string here. So if you look at this, this will be negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, and then negative 5. So this is how you can use negative indexing to access the character from the end. We also have string slicing. So for example, we have this hello string equal to hello here. And now let's look at how can we use string slicing on this string itself. First of all, slicing let us get a subset of a string. For example, hello string 1 colon 4 returns ELL. So why ELL? Because as I say, the index starts from 0. So now let's look at this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, when I say 1 to 4, means that I will be doing index 1, 2, 3, excluding 4. So remember that we are excluding the end digit. Therefore, it will be 1, 2, 3. So the answer will be ELL here. And next, leaving one side blank selects to the end or from the start, hello string 2 colon and then blank here returns LLO. So why LLO? Because 0, 1, 2, we start from this L here and then everything to the end. Therefore, the answer will be 2, 3, 4, which is LLO. At the same time, the step value can be used to skip characters. Hello string colon colon 2 returns HLO. So how do you get this answer? Basically, you can think of it step as in two characters at one time. So two characters at one time. And now let's go through together. So HE, two characters, and we take the first character. So H, and then two steps again. So L, and then two steps again. So it will be O. Therefore, the answer will be H, L, and then O. So this is how you can use step in string slicing. Lastly, a negative step value can be used to reverse a string. For example, hello string colon colon negative 1 returns OLLEH. So we always use this quite often to reverse a string. For example, I want to reverse this hello, I can just put colon colon negative 1 and we will be reversing this string. Therefore, the answer will be OLLEH. So this is how we can reverse a string just using string slicing. The next topic will be string concatenation. And now let's look at the first example here. So first of all, using hello string equal to hello, combine strings with the plus operator. So hello string plus open quotation world here returns hello world. Basically, you are just combining this variable with this string here, resulting in hello world here. We can also use join method to concatenate string. So let's look at this example here. The join method combines a list of strings. So for example, open quotation space closing quotation dot join hello comma were here. So what you are doing here is that you are combining this hello and were with a separator, which is this empty space here, resulting hello space and then were. So you can use plus or use join method to actually concatenate string. As a gentle reminder, be careful when concatenating non-string types. For example, hello string plus 3 will raise an error, but hello string plus string 3 will not. That is because Python does not automatically convert numbers or other types to strings in concatenation context. Use the string function to convert non-string types to strings before concatenating. Therefore, look at this example here. This is a string data type and this is an integer data type. And let's say you want to produce string, you have to convert this 3 into a string. So you can use str bracket 3 to convert the 3 into the string. Therefore, string plus string is equal to string. So this is how you can do string concatenation for different data types. And lastly, let's look at some string methods. So first of all, lower and upper convert case. For example, hello.lower returns hello. I will be converting all of this into lowercase. And then hello.upper returns hello all in capital letter. So this is actually quite straightforward. And the next method will be this method here. Replace old comma new. Replaces occurrences of the old string with the new string. So for example, hello, this is the string, dot replace L character with R character, returns hello. Means that I will be replacing all the L with this R here, resulting in hello here. Furthermore, we also have this split method, which breaks up a string into a list. So for example, hello world or split will return hello and world into a list or an array here. And the last method will be strip method here. So strip bracket removes leading and trailing white space. So for example, let's say your string has like a empty space at the front here and empty space at the back here. Using hello.strip will return hello. So normally, we will use this strip method when we handle text file. Because inside text file, normally people tend to type an empty space on an enter, resulting in a lot of empty spaces. So we will always use this strip method to handle all these special cases. As usual, let's look at some labs. For lab 1, it's actually quite easy. Basically, the question will be this one here. Reverse a string using slicing. So for example, I have the input hello here, and the output should be this O-L-L-E-H. So we are just reversing the string using slicing. So I've actually mentioned this in the video to reverse a string. For lab 2, convert a sentence into a list of words and make each word uppercase, print the list. So for example, this is a sentence. So this is the input. You have to break this sentence into a list of words first, and then you have to make each word uppercase. Therefore, the output is going to be this is a sentence. So remember that we have to break this string into a list first, and then I have to convert every single word here into uppercase. And the final lab will be this one here. Replace all vowel words in a sentence with a star. So vowel words are A, E, I, O, U. And now let's look at the example. So for example, the input will be this is a sentence, and the output should be this one here. THI, which is a vowel, will become star here, and then S star S star S star NT star NC star. So we are supposed to do this for this lab 3 here. Basically, find the vowel and then replace all the vowel with star here.